So with Jumpfest coming around the corner, many people are wondering in general whether we're going to get a PV or a key visual. And I've been very on the board of we're going to get a key visual at Jumpfest. However, at the current moment in time, we haven't got any stages to announce anything Bleach related. Naturally, more are going to be announced as time goes on, which I'm very excited about. However, we have some pretty big and significant news, which I think is important to address. As of today, of the recording of this video, we have had a leak of a new URL domain name registry. Because if you are new to these things, you usually have a URL that is being made to usually be used later on down the road. And if you know from the Bleach20thAnniversary.com website, this is just essentially what I would call a hub. So it's where you can get your quick links to everything like Burn the Witch, the Bleach Expo, etc, etc, Jump J books. The list goes on essentially. However, for the longest time, there has been one picture which you can see, URBark right here saying Anime Bleach Vows and Your Blood War, saying coming soon. And that's been like that for almost close to pretty much 2 years. And it seems to me that this link is going to be used very soon due to this new domain name. So let's get on board and talk about it, shall we? The new Bleach domain name is called bleach-anime.com. Now, if you are familiar with these kind of stuff, we had one recently about a year ago for Dragon Ball, and we had one for Chainsaw Man. Just ones coming from the top of my head, also Komi-san, but, you know, to talk about Shueisha properties, Dragon Ball recently had one a year ago, and that was to promote the new website and obviously the movie, and obviously Chainsaw Man, which after its leak actually had a new key visual a month or two afterwards, and that was announced at Jumpfesta. So usually when it comes to these things, it happens in quite quick succession. And the big question is this legit? Now, of course, there's many things to take into consideration here. Is that, yes, bleach-anime.com is going to be an anime-specific site. It seems that it's not being done by Shueisha, which is normal when it comes to animes, because usually it will be like a different company that deals with that, usually whether it's Toei for Dragon Ball or Bird Studios, or, you know, in Chainsaw Man's case, that has its own registry, individual registrant as well. There's many things to take into consider here. One, is it from Japan? Yes, it says right here, it's from Japan. Here's the phone number. The interesting thing to take into consideration here is the registrar URL, which is Onome, which they have done quite a few things, which I'm going to show you in a minute. And the same with the address, 261 Sakura Gakucho, and the tower, and it's in Shibuya, etc. So we have an address, and we have the company, which is the registrar, which is a registrar is usually ones that kind of they cement it, they kind of like reserve it for the rights holders later on. Usually that's how it goes. And we can see here for other Bleach sites as well, such as the 20thAnniversary.com, which I just recently showed you. This also isn't Shueisha either. This is a different organization which handles this website. The same with the Bleach Jump Exposition. You'll see again that the registrar is anime.com, and again the same address being used here. Same with Burn the Witch. They have the same address again here, same registrar URL. And we can look at Chainsaw Man. This was when it was leaked and when it wasn't public to people, that there's not much information, but again, anime.com or anime, I can't pronounce it. But yeah, there's this as well. And then as time went on, when it got public, you can see again that, you know, it counts here on a different provider. So if you want to add absolute certainty as well, you can see again Jump Bookstore, which is an official Shueisha website, is also handled by Anime as well as the same building that it is registered from. So at the moment, it is looking pretty legit. You know, if it is a fake, it's a very good fake. Everything here matches up with previous leaks in the past, previous website domain addresses and registrars. Also, another big thing as well, which I noticed, and I noticed this with Dragon Ball as well, it started in 2020, that's when it was registered, and the expiry is in 2020. And usually they do this with j-bleach.com from Shueisha. They usually like renew the license of the website or renew the registry every 2 years or so, and that's because obviously things can change, they might not want to use it anymore, etc, etc. Like, you'll have some series in Jump which, you know, get cancelled and they just don't renew it after a bit. So, you know, that's just to keep, you know, keep it fresh, keep it new and keep it relevant. In this case, which is very interesting, is that the creation date started actually 2 days ago, which is interesting. And you can see here the expiration date is in 2031. And it's interesting. I'm not going to look, if you want me to reach, I'll reach, right? Because again, it could be just a random number. However, this is 10 years of a Bleach domain name that's been taken, which means you usually have to pay for that longevity as well. So 2031, it's interesting because, as I said, and I've always said it in videos, Bleach is going to be used as a longevity series for Shueisha to have a passive income, you know, during, you know, Shonen Jumps, however they want to go with the magazine, whether they're going to have hit series, whether they're not, I don't know. But as I've always said, that a lot of money is going into this production. They want a long-term thing. And this is, if this is any number to sniff at, it tells me that this is going to go beyond Thousand Year Blood War arc. You know, we could get novels, we could get extra movies, and anything in between. But this is, and even movies. But this is huge. This is 10 years. Essentially, a Bleach website that's going to be made relevant. Because you don't have a website if it's not going to be made relevant. Because if you look at other series, old series, those websites simply don't exist anymore. Now, why is there this website? Now, if you don't know from back in the day, you know, usually if you had a series, such as like Naruto or Bleach, for example, they didn't really have dedicated websites back then. Usually, it would be a external link off of the studio. So it would usually be Studio Periot or Periot.com/Bleach or Periot.com/Naruto, and you'd have your own separate page on the Periot website in this case, or same with Toei, with Dragon Ball back in the day, etc., etc. That was quite common, but now this is a very specific, direct, its own website, pretty much like the 20th anniversary Bleach website that I just showed you earlier. Just like the Bleach Exposition, just like Burn the Witch, you're going to have a dedicated Bleach anime website, just like you do with like the Dragon Ball Hub that got recently announced a year ago. So again, that's why Bleach never really had a website, and this is why it's kind of exciting and new, because, you know, you're not getting a renewed version of Periot.com/Bleach. It seems like it's going to have its own thing, and we're probably going to find out a lot more information. So with that in mind, it's now going to be looking back at previous times leaks have happened of URLs, and then go from there. And what we know from previous leaks of URLs is that usually we get news between a month and 2 months after the registry has happened. And what does that say? Well, Jump Festa is around the corner, and it's possible we are going to get a key visual. It is almost like 95% to 99% certain at this point we're going to get a key visual, because they're going to want to open up this website with some kind of validity or exclusivity, and it's good for marketing especially as well. So, you know, are we going to get a PV? I still think it's too early. I think at this point, it's going to be a PV within 6 months, usually after Jump Festa, maybe 3-5 months from now. But a key visual is probably what's going to happen. And are we going to get a booth at Jump Festa or a stage? It seems like it's possible. I can't remember off the top of my head how Chainsaw Man and Jujutsu Kaisen had their key visuals announced, because again, like, I wasn't really paying attention. Either or, it seems like it's going to, we're going to get something in the next few months, whether it's at Jump Festa or not, I don't know, but we're going to get some exciting news, and there's a lot we can get from a website as well. So, and again, 2031 is a pretty significant date to have an expiration, because if you look at the other ones, like here's the Bleach 20th anniversary one, 2022, which again, they probably will want to discard Bleach 20th anniversary at some point in the future, because it is going to be a little bit irrelevant, because again, the 20th anniversary is a limited date in time. So, you know, that's going to be irrelevant when the 30th one comes around, or even the 25th one comes around. So this URL probably won't be existing any longer than a few more years at max, you know. Same with the Bleach Exposition 2022. Again, the Bleach Expo is going to be irrelevant once the event has ended. You can look here at the Burn the Witch one, which has 2023. It's a very interesting date and would make sense in terms of when it was created. So 3 year domain. And again, we can look at Chainsaw Man, which is expiring on actually next month. So this will probably get renewed. I have no doubt that this will get renewed at all, or they might change the domain name. We're not quite sure. But, you know, considering that, you know, Chainsaw Man is probably going to have its anime, you know, running soon, this is probably going to change. This is probably when they revamp the website. So it's very interesting. I'm excited, and I can't wait to see what we're going to have for Bleach in the upcoming few months. Like, there's going to be a lot of news, and I'm excited. So There's not really much to say to that. As I said, we have a company, an official company, which has done many jump series in the past. We've got a, you know, an address. So we know that this isn't some kind of forgery or some kind of fakety. We have, you know, some contact information. If it's fake, it's really, really good. So chances are I'm fully on board on this. We're getting a new Bleach anime website, and anyone that is excited for the Bleach anime, it seems that things are moving forward. As I've said in videos as well, key visuals usually don't take that long to make. It's literally just a pitch to show you what the character designs are going to look like, and usually it's not usually the final piece. For example, Attack on Titans wasn't the final piece of how it looked. So, you know, I'm a bit scared of when the key visual comes out, granted, because, you know, once we have it, that's what it's going to look like. So, you know, either we like it or we love it. And it's, again, that 50-50 of that bit of anxiety. But besides that, I think it's going to look great. So, as I said, key visuals take literally maybe a week to make, if not less. So, you know, once we get that, things are going to start moving along. And yeah. So tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Do you think the 10-year registry date has any sort of significance whatsoever? And if so, does this hype you up? I know you probably are hyped, but do you think we're going to get some movies, some games, or what do you think, you know, the Bleach anime having a 10-year expiry date means to you? That being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine David Hansen. As always, people, peace out.